Good morning, students. Today we are going to see a topic from power electronics. Yes, that is a boost converter. Boost converter is a DC to DC converter. The output DC voltage is greater than the input DC voltage, hence the name boost converter. We have seen the reason for the name. Now we can see the application. So this is a block diagram of photovoltaic power conditioning system. In this, you can see the DC to DC converter that is connected between the PV panel and the inverter. So all other allied devices are connected, but we are going to see the operation of DC to DC converter now. So let us move to the next slide. Now we are going to see how the boost converter works. It mainly consists of four components. You can see from the circuit diagram of boost converter, it has an inductor, a diode, and a MOSFET switch, and a capacitor connected across the load. So there are simple circuit, simple devices, only four devices. One is inductor, switch, diode, and a capacitor connected across the load. We can prove the type of converter from the discussion. The discussion has two modes of operation, mode 1 and mode 2. As we all know, there is two choice for a switch. It may be in closed condition or it may be in a open condition. Now assume the MOSFET switch is in closed condition, that is mode 1 operation. So this is a equivalent circuit of boost converter in mode 1 operation. We have assumed the MOSFET switch is on. From the previous diagram, you can see when the MOSFET switch is on, the inductor charges with this polarity as shown in the figure. So the supply is connected to the inductor. So starting point of the inductor acts as a plus and ending point of the inductor acts as minus. Since it is minus, the diode is reverse biased. You can see the diode DM. So the diode is reverse biased. So the load is disconnected from the supply. Now you can see a closed circuit consists of the source and the inductor alone. Another closed circuit is there. Now we are going to discuss about the first closed circuit only. So in this closed circuit, we are having the source that is charging the inductor. So as my earlier instructions, assume clockwise direction in the closed loop and write the Kirchhoff's voltage equation for the loop. So as we have assumed the current flow is in clockwise direction, that is arrow denotes minus to plus, so write it as a plus Vs, and the arrow denotes plus to minus in case of inductor. Therefore the voltage across the inductor is denoted as minus VL, that is equal to zero. Since we are having only two voltages, one is source voltage, another one is a voltage across the inductor. So source voltage is Vs positive, and drop voltage, the voltage in the inductor is charged by the source. Therefore it is a drop voltage. Therefore minus VL is equal to zero. Therefore VL is equal to Vs. We know the formula for voltage across the inductor, that is nothing but L into di by dt. So instead of VL, we are writing L into di by dt is equal to Vs. Di by dt is nothing but the change in current. Now we are assuming the t on time. Therefore the change in current during the t on, that is L into del I by t on is equal to Vs. So from this equation, we can write the equation for del I, that is del I is equal to Vs into t on by L. Similarly, for Tn, the formula becomes L into del I divided by Vs. So we have concluded two equations from the Tn period, mode 1. We have derived T del I and Tn. So del I is a change in current, that is I2 minus I1. That is a peak-to-peak ripple current of the inductor L. Now, here you can see the capacitor is omitted. Here, it is during the T of time. Here, see, the capacitor is omitted because the voltage across the capacitor and voltage across the load are same. For simplicity, we have omitted the capacitor. See the previous circuit diagram. When the switch is off, the diode becomes forward biased. Therefore, it connects the source to the load through the inductor. The diode becomes forward biased when the switch is off, because when the switch is off, the inductor discharges. So the polarity of the inductor is reversed compared to the polarity of the inductor during the charging time. So plus connected to the anode of the diode. Therefore, the diode is forward biased. Therefore, the load is connected to the source through the diode. It acts as a diode, acts as a closed switch. Now we can see the closed circuit from the source to the inductor, diode and load return to the source. Now we can write the Kirchhoff's voltage equation for the circuit. So the arrow denotes minus to plus. Assume clockwise always. The arrow denotes minus to plus Vs. Therefore, we have written as plus Vs. The arrow denotes minus to plus VL. Therefore, we have written as plus VL. The current is flowing from the load from positive to negative. Therefore, the V0 is taken as minus V0. You can see the arrow plus to minus, therefore minus V0 is equal to 0. So rewriting the equation, VL is equal to V0 minus Vs. Already know the formula for voltage across the inductor is del I by T off into L, that is L into change in current during the off time is equal to V0 minus Vs. Therefore, L into del I by T of is equal to V0 minus Vs. Therefore, del I is equal to V0 minus Vs into T of by L. And T of is equal to L into del I divided by V0 minus Vs. Here also, during the off time also, we have derived the change in current del I and equation for T of. Now, we are going to equate the value of formula for del I, which we have derived during the T on and T off. See the equation, equating del I. So during the T on time, del I is nothing but Vs into T on by L. During the T off, del I is equal to V0 minus Vs into T off by L. So rewriting the equation, we are going to find the type of converter. So we are particular about the output voltage. Therefore, the output voltage term V0 should be at the left hand side. So keeping the V0 at the left hand side and changing the all other terms to the right hand side, we can come to the equation V0 is equal to Vs into T by T off. But we are going to write the output voltage in terms of duty cycle, that is alpha. So for writing the duty cycle, the terms should be in T or T on. Therefore, we are writing the T off as T minus T on in the next line. So V0 is equal to Vs into T divided by T minus T on. We are writing T minus T on instead of T off. Now, divide the right-hand side numerator and the denominator by t. It will not change the value. Therefore, Vs t by t becomes Vs, and t minus t on by t becomes 1 minus alpha. That is, t by t becomes 1, and minus t on by t becomes alpha. Therefore, V naught is equal to Vs divided by 1 minus alpha. Now, we have to know about the duty cycle. The maximum value of duty cycle may be equal to 0.9. So, in ideal case only, it is possible to have duty cycle of 1. But the maximum value, let us assume 0.9, and the minimum value as 0.1. So, from this output voltage formula, if we substitute the alpha as 0.1 and the source voltage as 10, the output voltage becomes 11.11 volt for input voltage of 10 volt. The output voltage becomes 11.11 volt for the same input voltage of 10 volt. When the duty cycle alpha is 0.9, we can calculate the output voltage. The output voltage is 100 volt. So in either cases, the output voltage is greater than the input voltage. Therefore, it is concluded that the converter is a boost converter. Then we can derive the equation for change in current by substituting the formula T is equal to T on plus T off. We have derived the T on during the on time, and we have derived the T off during the off time. Substituting the formulas in this equation, we can find the value of formula for T. From that formula, we can derive the change in current as shown in the PPT. That is, change in current is equal to Vs into alpha divided by FL, where alpha is a duty cycle, F is a frequency, that is reciprocal of time, and L is a inductor value, where delta is a change in current through the inductor. Similarly, we can obtain the change in voltage across a capacitor, that is the change in voltage across a load. Both are same since they are connected in parallel. So we can derive the change in voltage as del Vc is equal to I naught alpha divided by Fc, where del Vc is a change in voltage across the capacitor, I naught is the output current, alpha is a duty cycle, and F is a frequency, C is the value of capacitor. So that's all about DC to DC boost converter. It is a DC to DC converter. It gives always greater voltage from the input voltage. Thank you.